guys, and welcome to another day's vlog with us, even though we've not been vlogging all that but the last couple of days. Anyway, thought I'd check in, say good morning, hope you're all having an amazing day, whatever you're doing with your day today. Anyway, starting today's vlog over at the studio. Come over here to do some cleaning, get everything bleached, try and get an idea of stuff that what are changing here, get some stuff put away, get some stuff thrown away, and yeah, basically try and get my life in some kind of order, because I just feel like I've just been leaving things, keep saying I'm gonna do it and then just don't do it. So today is one of them days where we try and get on top of everything. Sorry if you can't hear me, but Dave is hoovering. Mary Poppins. He just looked at me. Eh?
I've finished being Cinderella now.
Have you? You've finished being Cinderella now. Anyway, I'm going to crack on, show you some of the stuff we're getting up to. Maybe Dave might show you a little bit of what he's up to rather than rambling today. But yeah, as you know, we've got all this stuff here. You can always tell when Dave has been in the back of here because everything just seems to be a mess. And he never puts anything back straight, as you can tell just by looking at it. It's never very tidy when Dave's been in that cupboard. I don't know what is up with this camera. If it is looking off, I do apologise. But for some reason, this camera is just playing up. And we don't know whether Aurora's pressed something or we've turned it onto a setting that we just don't know. And it's just throwing out footage that's just not really that good. But I do apologise and we will get it sorted. We need to match it with the other camera. Because it did reset the other camera, and when we use the other one now, it just looks really like clear. And then for some reason, I mean, I think I did set this one, but I just didn't finish all the settings. So I'll probably do that later on tonight. Anyway, I'm gonna crack on, get some stuff done, because time is cracking on and we need to get things done, because obviously Aurora's in nursery. So, and we need to get as much done as we can while she's not here. We were, in fact, the boys' bedroom carpet is being fitted on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. So we need to literally empty their bedroom. And they've got a million Nerf guns. I said this before, but I've just had time to get rid of them. So we need to do that tonight. Hopefully get that done tonight. And also try and sell the beds.
Then you're getting new beds, aren't you?
You're getting new beds, but for the time being, they'll probably have to sleep on the mattresses on the floor until we get the new ones, and we've got everything else for the bedroom, and we've finished painting and stuff. There's no point in putting new beds up and then being in the way and us having to keep moving.
Just quickly as well, you know the debacle that went on with the beds. It's not that we can't afford the beds. It's that the beds, when we went to get them from B&M's,
yeah, they only had one.
They only had one, and then when we went back, one of the boxes was missing.
The lighting is really
when Davina went with Carl to pick them up, one of the boxes was missing out of it. So they have like box A, B, C, D.
Yeah, they seem to just like keep being box one box C was missing.
So we will get them. If not, we'll get something similar. But yeah, for now, we just need to clear the room. Like Sarah said, paint it. We need to get the carpet laid. Then we need to get the Venetian. We're getting like Velux blinds that come down.
Because we did even, we've seen like loads of good ideas.
The windows.
Where they used, what they called now, them wooden like pallets. We had a really good idea because they're into like Call of Duty and stuff. We were going to have the back wall painted, like get an artist to come out and paint the back wall. So we've not quite decided whether we want that done. And obviously we don't want to put beds there just in case we do decide we're going to have that done. And then we had this really cool idea where we'd have the bottom of the bed underneath the mattress made out of like wooden slats, and it had like something around it, so it was like a shelf basically. But I don't think it'd be convenient that for that type of bedroom. I think if they had a proper square bedroom, then that's probably something that we would have done. But because they're in a loft bedroom, there's just not very much space.
I need to
up
put
there.
In as well, because I really need to say this really quickly, because this is just maybe day like 10 times better. So we have updates when Aurora's in school. So she's got an update, Sarah's got an update, well, me and Sarah have got an update today saying Aurora's coming to nursery this morning without becoming upset at all throughout the day up to now. So that is fantastic, because Sarah will vouch for me, I'm brutal, aren't I? If the kids, if I see her going in that nursery upset, I'm like a baby, aren't I? I just don't like that.
She was really good this morning, actually. I got her out of the car and she didn't say, no. She usually goes, no. And I got her out and she just stood beside me and held my hand and walked to the nursery door. She was a bit quiet, like when she picked her up. She didn't really say bye to me, but she didn't cry, which is a start. So maybe next time we'll get a goodbye and a kiss. Obviously, I gave her a kiss. But yeah. It's really good, and like we get updates all day, what she's doing, what she's eating, which is just amazing. You just can't beat it. So anyway, there's a load of stuff in this room that I've got that I need to get rid of, like stuff that are used for baby shoots and like blankets and stuff. I'm just gonna get rid of them all, because the shoots that what start doing if I do not newborns, I won't be using them. They'll be proper wraps.
Did I tell you my mat was fixed?
Did he tell you his Mac is fit? So I don't want to keep rambling on. We're gonna go and get some stuff done. I'm probably not gonna video, because it'll just seem like I'm videoing and talking. So you'll literally see me, then me, then me, then me. So I'll probably get done what I need to do, and then I'll show you what we've got done. First of all, we are going to move this, because Dave keeps saying to me, there's nothing of mine in your room anymore. Oh yes, darling, there is this. So you can serve this back into your room, because that's where it's going. I have something here that belongs to you. Where do you want to put it? I don't know where you're going.
In there.
No, I don't want it in here.
But it looks good.
No, I don't want it in here.
Oh, did we tell you that we do hover boards? We do hover boards. Let me just tell you something about this hover board just really quickly. This hover board is an exact replica of the Back to the Future one, size, scale, more or less weight as well, maybe just slightly a little bit heavier, but everything, hand applied, vinyl, proper foot muff. Now remember, this is the proper foot guard that goes on it here. This isn't a cheap version of it like Mattel do. This, it goes right the way around. So yeah, if you're in the business for prop replicas and you've always wanted a proper Back to the Future hoverboard, you know where to come. Right here.
Okay, I just started in this room. Just started clearing these boxes out, so the majority of the stuff that was in here is now in this black bag to go to the charity shop. I've managed to just pack some of these into these, although these need bigger boxes, but I just thought this will make it look a little bit tidier for now. There's some stuff down there that will eventually probably go in another box in here, because I'll try and get rid of them drawers, so everything's just kind of on this side. I wish I would have shown you these before I actually emptied them, or you know, started sorting them out, because I've never seen so much clutter on shelves in my life, and there's still stuff up here that I need to sort out. I was expecting to get more done than I have, but I didn't realize there was so much to sort out. But anyway, we got some done. Something is better than nothing. There's still a few bits in here that I need to get rid of as well. But I just kind of did. There's a couple of tutus in there, and I'm not sure whether I want to keep them, just because they were Aurora's from her first birthday and when it was Mother's Day. So I'm just like really sentimental like that, and find it really hard to let go of stuff. So we probably will end up getting rid of them, so there'll be more space in there anyway. And then this I'm going to put in the other part of the room. We need to get a box for all this stuff, which goes to all this down here, and then that'll be all neat and tidy. And then I don't even know what this is up here. I think that's my printer, actually, my photo printer. And then I've started getting some stuff to go Crycut, which can will eventually be over here. But yeah, anyway, I just want to show you quickly. There's still loads of stuff. We need to get this wall painted, get this wall painted, get this TV on the wall. I'm going to get rid of this. In fact, I might even get Dave to take that to the tip. Yeah, and then this is the charity shop. And I'm not too sure what I'm going to do with them two Olaf Teddies. Probably just get Dave to take them to charity shop as well. So yeah, we're just going to go home now. Well, I'm going to go home. Dave's going to go to school. I was going to stay, but the mop is broke, so I can't do anything until I get a new mop. I can't mop anywhere, or I suppose, well, Dave's done most of the hoovering this morning, but I would use the other mop, and usually I just like mop around, but my back is so sore that I don't want to make it any worse. So I'll have to pick up a new mop today, and then I can come over tomorrow anyway with Aurora. Aurora can just be running around and playing, so I'll probably do that. And then I've got some blankets here, which I'm going to give to Davina for baby. And then I found these, so I thought these would be good to use to do some tutus on or anything else that I fancy doing. I thought it'd just be good to practice on these, although I have these colours I'm probably never going to use because they're just horrible. But yeah, or maybe I might just give them to the charity shop and just order some new ones. Maybe keep the white one, peach one, yellow one, just the general colours. Yeah, we'll see. Anyway, we're gonna go home. I'm gonna go home and then get some work done at the house, and then the kids will be back, and then it'll be time for Aurora to come home. So it is now 2:10, so we need to go. So I'll see you at home.
All right, guys, I am now over here at the studio. Back again, actually, because we were over here earlier today, me and Sarah. But I've come back over here because I needed to do a couple of masks for a friend of mine who's a tattooist. He's actually going to be doing my legs, so he's going to be doing a Mandalorian sleeve on my left leg, all black and white. One of the best tattooists in the world. In fact, Joe Rogan follows him. He's going over to tattoo Joe Rogan. Really funny, interesting stories that, like, didn't realise that he was in the studio down the road from us. He followed me, so he didn't realise that I was there. He then said, the stuff that you do is amazing. I said, well, you know, I'd be more than happy to do you some bits and pieces, helmets, stuff like that. He said, can you do me an axe? And like a barbarian sword and other bits and pieces, a Mortal Kombat mask. I said, yeah, no problem. So he said, well, we got talking and he said, you know, you want a Mandalorian. And he hasn't done any Mandalorian yet, so he said, I'd be more than happy to, when I have cancellations and spare time, for you to come in and he'll just do me legs. So I was like, obviously. And then he's going to tune these on my arm as well, because although they're alright, some of the bits aren't as good as they could be. So he's going to go over the old work and just make it look sweet, so it's going to look amazing. Oscar is over here with me playing Call of Duty. I am going to be sorting out the room, which is to the back of me there, which is the studio room. I'm going to be taking everything down. Why is it I can never seem to get away from Aurora? Which is a good thing, really. But I'm going to be sorting the main print room out. The sublimation room, which Sarah's showing you, which is over there in that room. There. That's now finished. All we need to do is just plug everything in and make sure that everything's working. And then we need to get a rhythm going in there from doing the mugs and everything else. I am putting some t-shirts up. I'm also going to be doing some other bits and pieces. I might transition as well into doing some bits and pieces for wrestling, and also some heavy metal bands like Metallica and Slipknot, because I know that Metallica and the Slipknot stuff, especially the masks for Slipknot, are really, 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 really popular, and people pay quite a bit of money for them, so I'm all for that. And then we've also got ICP, which is Insane Clown Posse, I think it's called. So they have like Juggalo cards or something like that, so I'll be doing them as well. But for the time being, I'm just happy doing what I'm doing. eBay is doing fantastic, Etsy is doing fantastic, Amazon, it's just Amazon. You get like an order, a helmet order or two, maybe every 1 to 3 months. So it's all right in that respect, because, you know, you're getting something in from somewhere else. And then also, we've got the website, which is doing amazing, which is going to update later this week with t-shirts, mugs and everything else on there. So you'll be able to get all that goodness over there. And as for Sarah, with Tutu Tulu. She is also doing her site and everything else, but on Instagram for the time being. She doesn't want to move over to her website just yet, which is fine. I've still built the framework for it. I've got the template up and, you know, a logo and everything else there, and categories and a shop part. So just adding the images. As you know, we had the images over there with them drop downs up there. It's very easy for us in here because obviously we've got a working studio. And then I think she's going to get some stuff here as well on the Infinity Wall, which is another fantastic thing in here. The Infinity Wall, of course, it was already in here, but we had to pay for everything in here. We had to pay for these, which, I mean, they're all right, but they're not Bowens, and she's had Bowens lights and stuff like that. These up here, though, these are Bowens. These are High Glide rails, which are very, very expensive. In fact, we've got a spare one down there that we need to list and get on there. I might give that to Mike, actually, to list, because he does a lot of eBaying, and he just takes like a... Well, he just takes the listing fee out of it and everything else. So just do it for us, for a favour. So, with that said, and on that bombshell, I am going to end today's vlog. Do not forget to smash the like button, subscribe if you're not already. Make sure you click the notification bell. It does nothing. Make sure you leave us a comment if you can, and we will see you guys tomorrow, because we do this every single day.